Willingham.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I'm Ron Stacker Thompson. I'm the artistic director of the Willingham and also the director of tonight's performance. A little bit about the play. I'm sure you've read or you should read in the program. Alfred Uhry created these characters from his family and friends, loved ones. So they are real people, combination of real people. Before the show actually starts, or the scene actually starts, we're in 1948, and Daisy, Miss Daisy, has had a crash of her car, and her son and the insurance company do not want her to drive anymore. And I want to read to you, these are Alfred Uhry's words on my little piece of paper here. Daisy, age 72, wears a summer dress and high-heeled shoes in 1948 at 72. Who wears that now, right? I mean, she was that kind of a person. Her hair, her clothes, her walk, everything about her suggests bristle and feistiness and high energy. See for yourself.
Mama!
No!
Mama!
No!
Mama!
I said no, Bully, and that's the end of it.
It's a miracle you didn't end up in Emory Hospital and decked out with funeral arms.
But even so, I have found
saying Idella has a vendetta against your silverware.
Stop being sassy. You know what I mean. I was brought up to do for myself. On Forsyth Street, we couldn't afford them. We did for ourselves, and I think that's still the best way, if you ask me.
Now, you sound like Governor Talmadge.
What a thing to say! I am not prejudiced. Aren't you ashamed?
I don't have time for this. Florine's gonna kill me.
Oh, I see. You all have plans for tonight.
Dinner with the Ansleys.
Oh, I see.
See what?
The Ansleys? Oh, I am sure Florine went out and bought herself another new dress. This must be her idea of heaven on earth, isn't it?
Mama, what?
Socializing with Episcopalians.
You know what? Ain't no need to drive you wherever you want for the time being.
I'll be fine.
I'll stop by tomorrow evening.
Well, how do you know I'll be there? I am certainly not depending on you for company.
Fine, Mama. I'll call before I stop by.
Do that.
But you know what? I still intend to interview colored men.
Oh, no!
Mama!
After the ball is over.
Oh, Mama!
After the break of morn. No! Oh, no!
Yes, Miss McClatchy, send him on in. Hulk, is it?
Yes, sir. Hulk Colbert.
All right, well, go ahead and have a seat. Gotta sign these papers, and Miss McClatchy will be fussing at me.
You keep right on with it, and I got all the time in the world.
Well, that's good. How long you been out of work?
Since back before last November.
What? That's a long time.
Well, you try being me out of work, Mr. Worthing. The hiring young and the hiring colored, and it don't seem like they're hiring much young no more. Mr. Worthing, y'all folks Jews, ain't you?
Well, yes. What makes you ask that?
Well, to tell you the truth, I'd rather work for Jews. People talk about they stingy and they cheap, but don't say none of that around me.
Well, it's funny you should say that. Well, where'd you work before?
Well, see, that's what I was getting at. One time I worked for this woman over in their little Five Points.
Mm-hmm.
What was that woman's name? I forget. Anyway. She president of the ladies auxiliary over yonder to the Ponce de Leon Baptist Church.
Uh-huh.
And she all the time be bringing up God and Jesus and do unto others. You know what I'm talking about?
No, but go on.
Well, one time this woman said to me, she said, Hope, come on back here to the back with me. I got something to show you. So I walk on back yonder and she got all these shirts and collars spread out on the bed.
Mm-hmm.
And they was yellow, nasty. Like they've been stuck up in a shipper robe and forgot about it. That's right. So she say to me, she say, these belong to my daddy before he passed, and we finna sell them to you for 25 cents apiece.
Oh, Lord. Well, what was her name?
That's what I'm trying to remember. What was that woman's name? Anyways, I was going on to say, any fool could see that the whole lot of them shirts and collars won't work a plum nigger.
Mm-hmm.
And them's the people calling Jews cheap. And I say to her, I said, yes, sir, I'll think about it, and I give me another job just as fast as I can. Where was that? With Mr. Harold Stone, Jewish gentleman, just like yourself. Judge.
Yeah.
Live over there on the Lovewater Road.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. No, I knew Judge Stone.
You don't say.
Yes, sir.
He gave me this here suit when he finished with, and this here necktie, too.
So, you drove for Judge Stone?
7 years to the day, near about. I'd still be driving for him if he didn't up and die. Then his wife missed on him, though she closed up the house and moved on down to Savannah. And she said to me, she said, Hope, come on down to Savannah with me. Well, you know, my wife dead by then and all. But I said, no, thank you. I ain't want to be away from my grandbabies. And plus, I don't get along well with that geeky trash you got down there.
Judge Stone was a friend of my father's as well.
You know what I mean? Oscar say you need somebody to drive for your family. What are you doing? taking your children to school and your wife to the beauty parlor and like that?
No, nothing like that. I don't have children.
Oh, that's a shame. My daughter, best thing ever happened to me. But you young, kid. I wouldn't worry about none.
I won't. Thank you. Who'd you drive for after just summer?
I drove a milk truck for the Avondale there through the whole war. You know, the one just for us.
Oh, all right. Well, I tell you what, though. What I need is somebody to drive my mom.
But let me ask you this, sir. How come she ain't hiring for a city?
Well, that's a delicate situation.
Oh, I see. She done gone around being a little. Well, no, it happened to them as they get up.
No, no. She's too much there. It's not safe for her to drive anymore, but she won't admit it. And to be honest with you, folks, I'm desperate.
I know exactly how you feel, Mr. Worthing. Mm-hmm. One time when I was out of work, my wife said to me, "Hope, you ain't gonna find another job?" And I said, "What you talking about, woman?" And I get me a job that next week working for that woman over at Little Five Points. Cahill, Miss Frances Cahill, that was her name. Then I go work for Jerry Stone, and he the reason I'm happy to hear y'all Jews.
Well, that's good. Well, my mama is high-strung. She don't want nobody driving for her. But if you're working for me, she can squawk all she wants. She can't fire you. Understand?
Sure do.
All right.
I hold on to it no matter which way she runs.
Oh, that's good.
When I was a little boy down there in the farm above Macon, mm-hmm. I used to have to wrestle hogs to the ground before killing time. Mm-hmm. Well, Mr. Worthing, ain't now hog got away from me yet.
That's good, because you're going to need it. Well, how's $20 a week, Sam?
Sound like me, you got your mama a chauffeur. Miss Daisy.
Good morning.
Right cool in the night, wasn't it?
Well, I wouldn't know. I was asleep.
Yes. What are your plans today?
That's my business.
Right about this.
Idella say we're running low on Dutch cleanser and coffee.
We?
Say we're running low on silver polish, too.
Street, and believe you me, I knew the value of a penny. My brother, man, he brought home a white cat one day, and Papa said we couldn't keep it because we couldn't afford to feed it. My sisters saved up money so I could go to school and be a teacher. We didn't have anything.
Look like you're doing all right now.
And I have ridden the trolley carrying groceries plenty of times.
Well, I just feel bad taking Mr. Werner's money for nothing. You understand?
How much is he paying you?
That between him and me, Miss Lindsay.
If it's more than $7 a week, it's robbery.
Special on doing up stuff in the kitchen all day long. I tell you what, while you gone on the trolley to the Piggly Wiggly, I sweep off your front steps. Sweeping your front steps?
No, all right to the Piggly Wiggly and then home. Nowhere else.
Yes.
Oh, wait a minute. You don't know how to run the Oldsmobile.
Oh, Miss Daisy, this ship like a third arm to me. Besides, this one here automatic. Any fool can run it.
Well, any fool but me, apparently.
Don't be so hard on yourself. You can't drive, but you probably do a whole lot of things I can't do.
The idea. Idella, I am off to the market.
And I'm right behind her. I just love the smell of a new car, don't you?
I am nobody's fool, though. I can see that speedometer as well as you can.
Yes.
My husband taught me how to run a car. And I remember everything he told me. And so don't you even think for one second that you are speeding. I can see it.
Well, we ain't going 19 miles an hour.
I like to go under the speed limit.
The speed limit 35, yeah?
The slower you go, the more gas you save. My husband told me that.
Barely moving now. Might as well walk.
Is this your car?
No.
Do you buy the gas?
No.
All right, then. Now, my fine son may think that I am losing my abilities, but I still can control what goes on in my car.
Yes.
Where are you going?
To the Big Wiggly.
Well, then why didn't you turn on Highland Avenue?
Biggle Wiggler ain't on Highland Avenue. It's on Euclid.
I know where it is, and I want to go to it the way I always go, on Highland Avenue.
But that's three blocks out in the way, Miss Day.
Go back. Go back this minute.
Well, I can't just jump out of the lane.
Go back, I said. If you don't, I will get out of this car, and I
will
walk. You can't
jump out the door. We're moving.
This is wrong. Where are you taking me?
To the store.
This is wrong. You have to go back on Highland Avenue. I have been going to the Piggly Wiggly since the day they set it up and opened it for business. This is the wrong way. You have to go on Highland Avenue.
Look, yonder the Piggly Wiggly.
Get ready to turn now. Oh, look out! There's a little boy behind that shopping cart.
I see that.
Pull in next to the blue car.
Well, we next to the door, right here.
Next to the blue car.
Yes.
I don't
the sun, it fades the upholstery.
Thank you.
find you in one piece.
Well, I want you to be here when he comes. I want you to hear it for yourself.
Hear what?
He's stealing from me.
Hulk, are you sure?
Well, I don't make empty accusations. I have proof.
What proof?
This. I caught him red-handed. I found this in the garbage pail, hidden under the coffee grounds.
A can of salmon.
Well, here it is. Oh, they all take things, you know. So, I decided to count.
You count?
I did. Silverware first, and then the linen dinner napkins. Mm-hmm. And then, when I went into the pantry and I turned on the light, the first thing I saw was a hole behind the corn bin. And I knew there were only 8 cans of salmon. I had 9. 3 cans for $1 on sale.
Very clever, Mama. So you made me miss my breakfast and a meeting at the bank over a 33-cent can of salmon. Here, Mama, you want 33 cents? You want $1? You want $10? Buy a pantry full of salmon.
I bully the idea. Waving money at me like I don't know what. I don't want your money.
Uh-huh.
I want my things.
Mama, a can of salmon?
It was mine. I bought it and I put it in my pantry and he went in there and he took it without saying a word. I leave him plenty of food every day and I tell him exactly what it is. It's like having little children around the house. They just want something, they go and take it. No, not a smidgen of manners and no conscience. And he will never admit to this. He'll say, "No, ma'am, I don't know nothing about it. I hate this. I hate living like this. I have no privacy."
Mama, come on now.
Oh, go ahead. Defend him. You always do.
Lord, you know what? If you want to drive yourself so bad, why don't you call the insurance company and figure it out? You know what? Take your blessed trolley. Take a taxi cab. Whatever you do, leave me out of it.
Oh, Boobly, now that is not...
I believe it's fixing to clear up out there.
Morning, Hulk.
Oh, Mr. Worthy. I didn't know you was here.
Looks like we're going to have a talk.
Oh, yes, sir. Let me just put these things away.
All right.
Oh, Miss Daisy. Yesterday, while you was out with your sister, I went and ate a can of your salmon. Now, I know you said eat the leftover pork chop, but they was kind of steep. Now, I'd buy you another can. You can go put it in the pantry for you.
Yes, thank you, Hope.
Be right with us,
please. Yes, sir.
Go upstairs and get dressed. Goodbye, son.
Bye, Mama. Almighty, a 33-cent can of salmon.
Care before I'm even cold.
Roosevelt's husband.
That's right. She asked me to bring them out here for her. She's not very good about coming. And I do believe it would have been Leo's birthday today.
Yes, yes. Oh, where they grieve it?
Well, I'm not exactly sure, but I think it's over there somewhere on the other side of that weeping cherry. You'll see the headstone. Bauer.
Yes.
What's the matter?
None the matter. Miss Daisy?
No, now, I told you, it's on the other side of the weeping cherry, and the tombstone says Bauer.
Yes. What does it look like?
What are you talking about?
Well, I'm talking about I can't read.
What?
I can't read.
Oh, that's ridiculous. Anybody can read.
No, I can't.
Well, then how come I see you looking at the paper all the time?
That's just it. I'm looking. I figure out what's happening by looking at the pictures.
Well, you know your letters, don't you?
ABCs, yeah. Just can't read.
Oh, stop saying that. You're making me mad. Now, if you know your letters, then you can read. You just don't know you can read. I have taught some of the stupidest creatures in my life. And all of them could read well enough to find the name on a tombstone. Now, the name is Bauer. Bauer. Now, what letter does B sound like?
Sound like a B.
That's right. Bauer. Now, That's the last part. Now, what letter sounds like R?
R?
So, the first letter begins with a
B.
And the last letter is a
O.
Buffer. Why, it almost sounds like Bauer, doesn't it?
It sure do. That's it?
Well, that's it. Now, go on over there like I told you in the first place and look for a headstone that has a B in the beginning and an R at the end, and that will be Bauer. What is wrong with my hat?
We ain't gonna worry about what's coming in the middle.
No, not that. This is enough for you to go find it. Now go on now.
Yes.
And don't come back here saying you can't, because you can.
Yes. Miss Daisy?
What is it now, Oak?
I appreciate this, Miss Daisy.
Oh, don't be ridiculous. I didn't do anything. Now, would you please hurry up? I am burning up out here.
It's better since your hat don't work.
Thank you.
beat with delight.
Oh, she makes an ass out of herself. She just has to go and stick a wreath in every window she's got.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and that silly Santa Claus winking on the front door.
I bet she had the biggest tree in Atlanta. The way you reckon she'd get them so low?
Oh, absurd. And you know, if I had a nose like Florie, I wouldn't go around wishing anybody a Merry Christmas.
I enjoy Christmas at their house.
Well, I don't wonder. You're the only Christian in the place.
She got that new cook.
Oh, well, Florie never could keep help. But of course, that's none of my concern.
No.
It's just too much running around. Garden club this, and junior league that. As if any one of them would ever give her the time of day. Oh, but she would die first before she'd ever fix a glass of iced tea for the Temple sisterhood.
You're right.
I just hope she doesn't take it in her head to sing this year. She's howling like she's got a bone stuck in her throat.
You done said a mouthful, Miss Daisy.
Oh, Hope, you didn't have to drive me out. Bully would have come and gotten me.
Well, I know that.
Well, so then why did you come?
That's my business. Ooh, would you look at this here? Miss Florine done put a Rudolph reindeer in the dogwood tree.
Oh my Lord. If her grandfather, old man Friday, could see this, he would, what is it you say? He would jump out of his grave and snatch her ball head. Now, it isn't a Christmas present.
No,
because Jews have no business giving Christmas presents. So you don't have to go blabbing about it to Florine and Boo.
It's strictly between me and you. Oh, baby, Mr. Worthing done seen this. He done turned up the high five.
Oh, my Lord. I hope I don't spit up.
Tell you this thing's got air conditioning? Yeah, but she said she don't like no air. Said give her a nickname.
Well, you know how much she fought me on it. Yeah. Well, it's time for a trade. Losing equity in it. I know the boat y'all missing.
Not me.
Oh, come on now. Not even a little.
I done bought it.
You what?
Already squared the papers away with Mr. Red Mitchell down at the coffee place.
Well, for how much?
Well, that's between him and me.
You could have saved a ton of money if you would have bought it from Mama.
Your mama in my business enough as it is. Doesn't make it no car payment for her, no sir. Well, this here mine the regular way.
You right. Well, it's a great car. I mean, nobody know better than you.
Best ever come off the line. Of course now, if she don't take to this new one, I'll let her ride in this here every night again.
Well, that's mighty nice of
her. You know, we do what we can.
Uh-huh.
You know, I would do some of my poetry.
It's 7:03.
Yes. You say we leave at 7:55.
At the latest, I said.
Now, Miss Daisy, what you doing bringing all this here out in the house by yourself?
Well, who was here to help me?
Now, you know it don't take no more than 5 minutes to load up this here car. You finna break both your arms and your legs both before we even get out of Atlanta. You taking on too much.
Well, I hate leaving things to the last minute.
What you talking about? You ready to go the last week and a half?
Oh, don't touch that.
Sure is rather pretty. That Mr. Walters' present.
Well, it's fragile. I'll hold it on the back seat with me. Oh, ho, ho, ho. You nearly missed us.
I thought you were leaving at a quarter of.
Florine sent this for Uncle Walter. It's not a snake, Mama. It's not gonna bite. I think it's notepaper.
How appropriate. Uncle Walter can't see.
Maybe so.
You know, it's so wonderful how you show such an interest in your uncle's 90th birthday.
Mama, you know I can't go with you to Mobile. I've got the convention in New York. You know that.
The convention starts on Monday, and I know what else I know.
Oh, Mama, leave Florine out of this. She sent for those tickets 8 months ago.
My fair lady, more important than your own flesh and blood.
Mama.
All those Christians will be so impressed.
I can't talk to you when you're like, I'm gonna talk to Oak.
We are supposed to be in Mobile for a late supper tonight.
You'll get there.
Oh, I almost forgot. They're fixing crab. They go to so much trouble.
Lord, I don't know how you're going to make it in the car with her all day.
Oh, she don't mean nothing by it. She just worked up.
Well, I'm glad you feel that way. Well, here's $50 in case you get in trouble. Now, don't show Mama that. You got your map?
I think that's where she went back for. She must have forgot it. You know she's gonna study it every inch of the way.
You're right. Well, I'll be at the Ambassador Hotel in New York.
It is 7:16.
You should have a job on the radio telling the time.
I want to miss rush hour.
Well, give Uncle Walter a kiss for me and tell everybody I love him.
Did you get the air conditioner?
air conditioning fixed. I don't know what for. You'll never allow me to turn it on.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Good luck. Good job.
About the first time that I went to Mobile. It was for Uncle Walter's wedding, and I was 12. We went on the train, and I was so excited. I had never been on a train before, and I had never been in a wedding party, and I'd never seen the ocean. But Papa said it was the Gulf of Mexico, and not an ocean. But it was all the same to me. And I remember, we went on a picnic, and someone must have taken us bathing, because I asked Papa if I could dip my hand in the water, and he started laughing, because I was so timid. And then I tasted the salt water on my fingers. Isn't it silly to remember something like that?
Well, no silly than what most folks remember. You talking about the first time. I'm going to tell you about that first time I left the state of Georgia.
No. When was that?
About 25 minutes back.
Oh.
That's right, first time. My daughter, she married a Pullman porter, and they all the time going to St. Louis, Detroit, New York, talking about snow up to her waist and riding in the subway car. And I say, that's very nice, Tommy Lee. I just don't see the need. So this ain't, huh, Miss Davis? This Alabama. And I tell you what, it ain't looking like much so far.
Well, it's prettier on the other side of Montgomery.
So you say. Pass me up one of them peaches, please, ma'am.
Oh, God.
What?
Oh, my God.
What was wrong?
That sign back there said Phoenix City, 33 miles. We're not supposed to go to Phoenix City. We are going the wrong way.
Well, maybe you read the sign wrong.
I did not. Stop the car. Stop the car. Look in here. You took a wrong turn at Opelika.
Well, you took the turn with me, and you got the letter.
I was fixing lunch. Turn around and go back.
It ain't been no more 25 minutes since we turned.
Oh, I am such a fool. I had no business getting in this car with just you by myself. I should have taken the train, but you know, Booley made me. I'd be safe if I was on the train. I should have taken the train.
Yes, you should have.
I missed it now. They made crab for me. Minnie always makes crab for me. She goes to so much trouble. All ruined now. Oh,
Daisy, we got to pull over.
What? Is there something wrong with the car?
No. I got to be excused.
What?
I got to make water.
Well, you should have thought of that when we turned around that day at the Standard Oil Station.
Colored can't use no toilet at the Standard Oil, and you know that.
Well, we don't have time to stop now. We'll be in Mobile soon. You can wait.
Yes. No.
Well, I told you to wait.
Yes, I heard what you had to say, but
what
I had to get out of this car.
What do you think you are doing?
And how you think I feel having to ask you drink water like I'm some damn dog.
Oh.
I ain't no dog. I ain't no child. I ain't just some back to neck you look at when you go wherever it is you got to go. I'm a man. Nearly 72 years old and I know what my body for. I'm finna go on down this road and I'm gonna do what I got to do. And I'm taking the key with me.
Oh.
Well, hell yes, Mr. McClatchy, send him on in.
Well, Hope, what in the hell are all this pleasure for? Isn't it your day off?
We got to talk.
About what?
It's Mr. Sinclair Harris.
My cousin Sinclair.
His wife.
Jeanette.
You want to talk funny?
She's from Canton, Ohio.
She done gone and tried to hire me.
For what?
Well, she called over to the house when she know Miss Daisy out, and she say, Hope, how they treating you over there? You know how she talk like she got a nose stuff up? And I say, fine. And she said, well, if you ever looking for a change, you know where to call.
Damn,
I thought I'd tell you about
no,
it.
No, I'll be goddamn.
Ain't she a man? She talking about name your salary.
I see. And did you?
Do what?
Name your salary.
Oh, come on, Miss Worth. I ain't thinking about working old trash with somebody like her.
Uh-huh. But you got your thinking, didn't you?
Well, you might could say that.
Name your salary.
That's what she said.
Well, how's $65 a week sound?
Sound pretty good.
Uh-huh.
75 sound better.
Oh, I see. Uh-huh. Starting next week?
That's mighty nice of you, Mr. Worthen.
Mm-hmm.
I sure appreciate it. Mr. Worthen, you ever had folk fighting over you?
No.
I tell you what, it sure feel good. Deliver milk for the Avondale Dairy. Ain't too much to it.
Oh, I
slipped around a little bit coming around Briarcliff, but ain't nothing happened. Other folk bumping into each other like they in the funny papers. I figured your stove out, so I stopped by the 7-Eleven. I know how you had to have your cup of coffee in the morning.
Oh, Hoss, how sweet of you. Oh, sit.
Ooh. We ain't had no good coffee around here since our deli pie.
Oh, you are right. You know, I can fix her biscuits, and you can fry her chicken, but nobody can make Adela's coffee. I don't know what she did to it.
I don't know neither. Every time I see the hit parade, it put me in mind of Adela.
You're right, yes.
Sitting up there in a chair, her daughter says, spry as flowers in the springtime. Watching the hit parade that the Lord sent every Saturday. Then one time during the Lucky Strike Extra, she belched, and boom, she was gone.
Well, Adela was lucky.
Well, I expect she was.
Where are you going?
Well, take off this here overcoat and figure out something to do.
Well, I didn't think you'd come today.
What you mean? That ain't my day off, is it?
No, but there's nothing for you to do around here except keep me company.
Well, I see can't I make us a fire.
Oh, well, eat whatever you want in the icebox, because it's all going to spoil anyway.
Yeah.
But don't forget to wipe up what you get on my kitchen floor.
What you think I am, Miss Daisy? A mess?
Yes. That's exactly what I think you are.
All right, dear. All right.
Hello?
Mama, Pump, the lines will be fixed this afternoon. Set's all on the radio.
Well, Bullet, no, you stay right where you are. Hulk is with me.
Well, how in the hell did he manage that?
Well, he's very handy.
Hello? Never said loving things about Hulk.
Well, I didn't say I loved him. I said he was handy.
Uh-huh.
Oh, Bully, are you trying to irritate me in the middle of an ice storm?
Bye, Mama.
Bye, Bully.
Temple this morning, Miss Daisy.
Well, why not? What in the world is the matter with you?
Somebody done bombed the temple.
What? Bombed the temple?
Yes, that's what that policeman back there said it happened about a half hour ago.
Oh, Lord. Oh, my God. What, were there people there? Was anybody hurt?
Didn't say.
Who would do that?
You know as well as I do, always be the same woman.
Oh, I don't believe it. It was a mistake. I am sure they meant to bomb the conservative synagogue or the Orthodox. My temple is reformed. Everybody knows that.
It don't matter to them people. A Jew is a Jew to them folks.
Well, I don't believe it.
I know how you feel. One day when I was a boy about 11 or 12 years old down there on the farm above Macon, one day my friend Porter, his daddy hanging from a tree, and the day before he was laughing with us and pitching horseshoes, talking about Porter and me gonna have strong, good right arms just like him. And the there he is, hanging up yonder, his hands tied behind his back, and the flies all over. I seen it with my own eyes, and I threw up right there where I was standing. Go ahead on and cry.
I'm not crying.
Yes.
The idea. Why did you tell me that?
I don't know. It just seemed like this here mess put me in mind of it.
Well, that's ridiculous. That had nothing to do with the temple.
So you say.
We don't even know what happened. How do you know that that policeman was telling the truth?
Why that policeman gonna go and lie about a thing like that?
Well, you always get everything wrong anyway.
Miss Daisy, somebody done bombed that temple and you know it too.
Go on. I don't want to hear any more about it.
I'll see if I can't get you out of here. Get you home. You feel better if you home.
I don't feel bad now.
Miss McClatchy. Oh, you always recognize my voice. What a shame that a wonderful girl like you never married. Miss McClatchy, is my son in? Oh, no. Don't get him out of a sales meeting. That's all right. Just give him a message. Tell him that I bought the tickets for the UJA banquet. Yes, the United Jewish Appeal banquet honoring Dr. King on the 17th. Oh, aren't you so sweet to say that? And now listen here, I don't want you to worry because my cousin Tilly in Chattanooga, she got married for the first time at 57. Oh, he's out of his meat. Tell him I'm here at home. Bye-bye.
Mama!
ageless appeal.
Well, Miss McClatchy gave me your message.
Well, Florine is invited too.
Thank you very much.
I guess Hope should drive because it'll be crowded.
Well, Mama, we're gonna need to talk about this.
We'll talk about what?
The feasibility of this.
Well, fine, you drive. I thought I was being helpful.
Now, Mama, you know I believe that Martin Luther King has done some mighty fine things.
Bully, if you don't want to go, why don't you just come right out and say
so? No, now you know how I feel about him. You know I want to go.
Of course, but, Florine...
No, leave Florine out of this. You know I still got to conduct business in this town.
I see. So the Worthing Company will go out of business if you attend the King Dinner.
Not exactly. Now, you know there's men in this town that wouldn't like it. Now, they wouldn't say it to my face, but they'd snicker and talk behind my back, call me old Martin Luther Worthing, or something like that. And then I noticed that my banking business wasn't being handled by the top dogs. And Jack Raphael at Ideal Press, he's a New York Jew instead of a Georgia Jew. And you know how it is dealing with Jews. Best ones come from New York, don't they? So some of them boys might start sending work to Jack, to old Martin Luther Worthing. Now, I don't know if it'll happen, but that's how it works. And look, Mama, if we don't use those tickets, somebody else will use those tickets. And the good Reverend Martin Luther King will never know the difference, will he?
If we don't use those tickets, what? I'm not supposed to go either.
Mama, you can do whatever you want.
Oh, thanks for your permission.
Mom, can I ask you a question? When did you get so fired up about the Reverend Martin Luther King? There's a time I heard a different story.
Booley, I told you before, I have never been prejudiced.
And why don't you ask Hope to go to dinner with you?
Oh, that's ridiculous. I mean, he wouldn't go.
Why don't you ask him and see?
I don't know why you're still driving. You can't see.
Yes, I can.
Well, you didn't see that mailbox.
How do you know what I didn't see?
It nearly poked through my window. And this car's all scratched up.
There ain't no such thing.
How do you know you can't see? Brand new car, too.
That car be 2 years old come March.
Oh, well, you forgot to turn.
Ain't this here done at the Biltmore?
Oh, you know it is.
But the Biltmore is straight this way.
You just know so much.
Yes, I do.
I have lived in Atlanta all my life.
Mm-hmm. And ain't run a car going on for 20 years.
You know, Booley said the silliest thing the other day.
Is that right?
Well, he's too old to be so foolish.
Yeah. What is that?
Well, he was talking about Martin Luther King. I guess you know him, don't you?
Martin Luther King? No.
Oh, well, I was sure you did. But you heard him preach.
Over the TV, same as you.
I think he's wonderful.
Yeah.
But then you can hear him anytime you want. I mean, all you have to do is go down there to the, what is it?
Ebenezer
Baptist Church. Any Sunday, and there he'll be.
What you getting at, Miss Daisy?
Oh, well, it's silly, but Booley said that you wanted to go with me to this dinner tonight. Did you tell him that?
No.
Oh, well, I didn't think so. I mean, what was
would the point be? You can go and hear him anytime, whenever you want.
You on the front door or the side door to the Biltmore?
Oh, the side door. Isn't it wonderful the way things are changing?
Mm-hmm. Miss Daisy, what you think I am?
What do you mean?
You think I'm some son sitting up here don't know nothing about how to do?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Invitation to this here didn't come to mail a month ago. Did be you wanted me to go with you. How come you wait till we in the car all the way for you to ask?
All I said was Booley said you wanted to go. You are welcome to come. Oh, my stars. Aren't you a great big baby?
Never mind, baby. Next time you want to ask me to go somewhere, you ask me ready.
Well, you don't need to carry on so much.
Talking about things changing. They ain't changed all yet, but...
Oh, honestly.
I'll help you to the door.
No, thank you. I can help myself.
Hello? Mr. Worthing?
Hope? How are you?
Tolerable, Mr. Worthing.
What can I do for you?
It's your mama.
What about her?
She worked up.
Well, Hope, what's the difference between today and any other day?
No, this here ain't the same.
Hope?
Yes, she thinks she teaches school. I'm real worried about it. She ain't making sense.
All right. I'll be right there.
Hope?
Yes,
what did you do with my papers?
Ain't no papers, Miss Daisy.
I had my papers all corrected last night, and I put them right here so I would have them before I go to school. Now, what did you do with them?
You talking out of your head.
Oh, the children will be so disappointed if I don't give them their homework back. I always give it back the next day. That's why they like me. Now, why aren't you helping me?
What you want me to do, Miss Daisy?
Give me my papers, I told you. It's all right if you move them. I won't be mad with you. But I've got to get to school. Or my class, I'll be late. And who will take care of them? They'll be all alone. Oh, God, I did everything wrong.
Come over here and sit down before you mess around and fall and hurt yourself.
It doesn't matter. I'm so sorry. It's all my fault. I didn't do right, and it's so awful.
But there ain't nothing awful except the way you carry on.
I can't find my papers, and the children are waiting.
No, they ain't. You ain't no teacher no more.
Oh, I'm sorry. It's all my fault.
Ain't nothing the matter with you.
No. Go on now.
Your mind just gone and took a turn this morning, that's all.
Go on now.
You snap right back if you just let yourself.
I can't. I can't.
You a lucky old woman, you know that?
It's all a mess. It's all a mess. And I can't do anything about it.
You have to do for your time, and you got people care about what happened to you.
I'm being in trouble. I don't want to be in trouble.
Look, you want something to cry about, I take you up to the state home, and I show you what's laid out there at home.
Oh, God.
And I bet they ain't taking on what you doing this morning.
Oh, the children, my poor children, they're waiting.
Miss Daisy, you keep this up, and I promise you, Mr. Worthing, you'll call that doctor, and that doctor will put you in the insane asylum before you know what hit you. Is that the way you want it to be? Huh?
when I first came over here? Come on, Miss Daisy, that thing been in the junkyard 15 years or more. I'm driving your next Elias car now. 63 Cadillac. Running fine as wine.
You ought not to be driving anything the way you see.
Now, how do you know the way I see unless you can look out of my eyes?
Oh.
Yes.
You are my best friend.
Come on, Miss Daisy, you
no,
just...
No, really. You are... You
Mr. Worthing.
Well, Hulk, it's good to see you. You didn't drive all the way out here yourself?
Oh, no, no. I don't drive no more. My grandbaby raised me out here.
Well, Lord Almighty, is she old enough to drive?
Michelle, 37.
Well, I didn't know that.
She teach biology over there at Spelman College.
Oh, I had no idea.
Yeah.
Well, I think I've gotten everything out of the house. Is there anything you like for Goodwill comps?
No, sir. My place for the busting there as it is.
All right. Well, feels strange selling this place while Mama's still alive.
Yes, I agree.
Well, I didn't say I was going to tell her.
You right there.
Mm-hmm. Well, she hasn't stepped inside the front door in 2 years. I don't know. I know I'm making the right decision.
Yeah. Don't get me in.
Yes, sir. Well, Hope, I want you to know, as long as you're there to receive it, you'll continue to get a check.
I appreciate that, Mr. Worthing.
Yes, sir. You rest easy about it. Now, I'm sure it's hard to get out there to see Mama nowadays.
Well, it's hard not driving. That place ain't on no bus line. I take the taxi sometimes.
Well, I'm sure she appreciates it.
Some days she better than others. Who ain't?
Mm-hmm. Right. Well, we gotta get going. You got a turkey dinner to get to, as do I. Why don't you call your granddaughter, tell her I give you a ride home? All right.
Thank you.
I brought with me.
Morning, Miss Daisy. Keep yourself busy.
Oh, she certainly is. Jewelry making. Mama, how many times a week they got you doing that? Pins, bracelets, all kinds of things. She's like a regular Tiffany's.
Ain't that something?
Mm-hmm, yes, sir.
You know, Hope, I thought about you the other day.
Saw an Avondale milk truck driving down the expressway.
You know me.
Big monster of a thing. Must have had 16 wheels. I wonder what you would have thought driving about.
Oh.
Yes, Mama.
Hope came to see me, not you.
I know. This is one of her good days.
Doreen says happy Thanksgiving, Mama. She's in Washington, D.C. now. You remember? She's a Republican National Committee woman now.
Good God.
Mama?
Why don't you go and charm the nurses?
Well, I guess she wants you all to herself. You're a doodle, Mama.
Still paying you?
Every week.
How much?
That between him and me.
Highway robbery. How you doing?
Doing the best I can.
Me too.
I guess that's all there is to it then. Look here. You ain't got none of your Thanksgiving pie. Let me see if I can hear you.